Welcome back, everybody. This is Primus, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make this awesome lighthouse I made the other day. Nothing really too fancy to it. I'm trying to get back into that Greymor style of building here, as opposed to my Nordic style. I'm trying to just experiment around, and I wanted to build a lighthouse. So you're going to build a lighthouse too, because I want you to. Let's get started building this puppy. Now what we're going to want to do is you're going to want to start off with this design right here. Basically what it is it's a double pillar, a three block gap, another double pillar, and so on and so on. We got this one guy in the middle here. He's just really for aesthetic effect. On the inside, we're going to be building like a staircase around him. Okay, so first thing we want to do is we want to build these guys up so they're five blocks high. So they're already one block high, so we're going to go up four, like so, and we're just going to continue this all around. So, and I mean, if you want to build this guy up in the middle, that is fine by me. Now what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to place these things, some outsticking pillars on the tops of these things. I know, very original, haven't done that before. We're going to go through and place some buttons on them as well, because these are going to face the outside. And there we go. Now what we're going to want to do is we're going to work kind of from the bottom up. So we're going to start off by placing two pillars outside like that, make them go inside like that. Then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to fill this landscape out a little bit so it looks a little bit more natural. There we go. And what we're going to want to do is, in my case, put some of that down. What we're going to want to do is we're going to go into my inventory because I totally replaced it with something. We're gonna put a stone brick stair there, a cobblestone slab there, and repeat there. We're gonna put a actual cobblestone block there. Then we're gonna put two more blocks there, and we're gonna fill this thing up to there with cobble. Now we're gonna have to do a little bit of an interesting design. We're gonna have to place it like that, and then upside down stone brick stairs, and again over here, sideways stone brick stair, and then upside down stone brick stair. We're just gonna support that pillar with two more stone brick stairs. I know, it's a lot of stone brick. Get used to it. We're gonna put two stone bricks up there, and then we're gonna put a log there and two cobblestone slabs on top of that. So what we're gonna want to do now is, again, just repeat this on all the other sides. I'm gonna do one more for you, and then I'm gonna do some fancy editing, because I do not want to make you guys sit through that, but kind of brutal. Alright, so I'm going to do it quickly here. Block there, block there, block there. Build up with blocks. Block. Uh-oh, wrong block. Block, block, block. And this is just to kind of drill it into your minds, you know. Trust me, it takes forever to memorize this. Like that, and that. Boom. Now it's boom. Okay, so now that that's done, we got to work on the middle here. And what we're going to do is we're going to just kind of lay down a little bit more of that just for some support. We're going to put two stone brick stairs there. We're going to build this up by two. We're then going to do something fancy like that. We're going to put two cobblestone on the edge like so. We're going to go and grab us some cyan clay, because you guys know I love this stuff. We're going to do something like that. And then we're going to place two upside down stone brick stairs and a stone brick in the middle. We're also going to do that and place a block there. Now, what we want to do is we want to place a row of stone brick stairs up there, or cyan clay, my bad. We're going to place two upside down oak wooden stairs. I haven't tried this with any other kinds of wood. I don't know if it would look good or not. So that's the basic idea. Again, I'll repeat it once more for you. Up like so, like that, and we're gonna build our cobblestone up in the middle, too high, and then we're gonna place our cyan. We're gonna do this fancy thing, block in the middle, and then two upside down. We're gonna place it on top of that, and then we're gonna do our little wood aesthetic thing. And that's how it's going to go. We're just going to have to repeat that along the whole outside. And that's pretty much our first tier. Now we're going to move on to the second layer, or second tier, whatever the frick you want to call it. What we're going to do is we're going to raise these pillars on the far corners up by 3. We're going to raise everything else up by 2, though. So all these logs are getting themselves a lift job, like so. Yeah, we can bring that guy up if you want. It doesn't matter. And we're going to place some oak wood stairs right there and there, I guess, if you wanted to. I'm just going to do it for demonstration purposes. And then what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to put a stone brick stair there and there. A piece of cobblestone on top of that. Some upside down stone brick stairs there and there as well. We are going to place a cobblestone block there and then 2 stone brick blocks on top of that. This is going to give us a cool window shape. I really like this. Now we're going to go ahead and repeat this on all the other sides. We're going to place 2 stone brick stairs there. Again, like so, like so, like a so, and build it up like that. And there we go. Another tier here. Now we're gonna place some stone brick stairs around the whole outside, like so. It's gonna give us this. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna choose plain old cobblestone and we're gonna create a ring in the middle, just like that. That's what we're gonna build off of. We're gonna take some logs, build up 4, like so. We are going to put a wooden block at the top, or I'm just going to use some half slabs stacked on top of each other. And we're going to connect all these wooden beams like so. Now, what we're going to want to do is we're going to come through here and we're just going to fix it up. It's going to look nice. What we want to do is we want to place 2 stone brick blocks there. Place a upside down cobblestone stair there. Place 2 right side up stone brick stairs. 2 upside down, like I don't know what you'd call it, angled cobblestone stairs. Not cobblestone, dang. Stone brick. Use stone brick. There we go. And we're going to place 2 more blocks on top and another upside down stone brick stair. You've got to be kidding. It's cobblestone. Stone brick, cobblestone. Stone brick, cobblestone. I need help. Okay. And we're going to place some upside down wooden supports like so. And to fill in kind of this wooden pier area and some other little details, we're going to take some fence gates. We're going to take some fences and some iron bars. So what we're going to do here is fence gate in the middle and then 2 fences on either side. You've seen me do this in my Greymor houses. And we're going to place some pieces of fence on the bottom there. Then we're just going to fill the rest of that pillar up with some iron bars. Guys, bear with me if my voice is starting to get a little scratchy here. I've been recording for quite some time now, and it's starting to take over my voice. So, nonetheless, let's continue on. What we're going to want to do is we're going to want to take some more oak. We're going to build up 7 more blocks. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And we're just going to do the same on all sides, like so. And boom, there we go. And what we're going to want to do is we're going to start to make like a mini roof here that this kind of final stage will ascend out of. So what we're going to want to do is we're going to place 2 upside down stone, or it's not stone, it's wood, oak stairs there. We're going to place 2 or some more oak planks like so. Obviously, we're going to have to continue this on the other side. I'll just show this to you again real quick. like so, and then kind of work your way down like that, yeah. And we're gonna take some more stairs. We're gonna place them against these pillars here and get this cool kind of roof shape look. What we're gonna want to do now is we're gonna want to place some fences there, there, and there. If you're doing it like me, we're gonna kind of go up and put some iron bars on top of them. And we're gonna take some stone or cobblestone walls, and we're gonna do this kind of same pattern but with heavier materials on the outside, like so. We are then going to go through with some more stairs and kind of create more like upside down supports against those pillars. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna go through and place, we're gonna put a stair, upside down stair on the far outside here, but on the insides we're gonna place some normal blocks, like the slabs. Then we're gonna put a thing of cobblestone inside each of those guys, and that should be it. Start the roof now, and it's way easier than you think it is. It looks complicated, but it's not. And I actually screwed up in the bottom stage here. We only want to go up 6. We can just get rid of those. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take some stone brick stairs, normal stone brick, put it like that. We're gonna put some stairs on top of that guy, just like so. We are going to continue this, like just build a cross across here, and then we're gonna build it up again in another tier. Like so. We're gonna put one block there. We're gonna put a cobblestone wall on top of that, and then two fences just to kind of give it that cool look. We're then gonna come through here and place a block of wood, just normal oak wood there. We're gonna place two cobblestone walls, a fence, and a iron bar on there. Like so. I'm really starting to get into the iron bars. I haven't been using them, but man, do they look good. Like so. And that's pretty much it for the outside. Like, this is pretty much the structure of the thing. That being said, however, we still have to put in what you may notice is missing, a door. So basically, we're going to pick a side that we want the door on. I think I'm going to go with this just because the terrain flows into it quite nicely. And what we're going to do is we're going to basically come through here, just kind of knock out this, and then knock out this, and take out all of that, and that's pretty much going to be our doorway. Again, what I like to do is randomize it a little bit down there, just kind of ease it into the inside of the lighthouse here. What we're going to do now is we're actually going to go through and work on the interior. I'm not going to put furniture or anything, but I want to kind of show you guys how to how I did the interior, and it's nothing special. Okay, so we're gonna want another floor here, just so people can like look out and kind of just see the whole window thing. Get some use out of that. I think my voice is actually starting to get scratchy now. It's starting to sound like I'm freaking like a smoker or something, just because I've been recording for like an hour and a half now. I'm talking to myself for an hour and a half now. All right, on top of here, we're gonna pretty much, as you can see, I went through and just used wood on the whole thing. Last stage, I like to use stone brick. It just provides contrast, and this is where we're gonna be keeping the fire. So you could just do that or something. I don't care. One thing that's wrong that I don't like about this lighthouse is that when you get up to the top, you can't use a spiral staircase all the way to the top. That sucks. I love spiral staircases. Just because the way the fire thing is gonna work out here, you really just can't put a spiral staircase in without really ruining the look. So what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be putting, I think, a ladder up to here. I think that's what I did. And then we're going to build the spiral staircase down from the rest. So, just to show you how I build spiral staircases, I'm not going to make you sit through the whole thing, but what I do is I just kind of go up with some slabs. Just, you know, there's nothing crazy complicated or anything here. It's just me placing some slabs. Okay, so I finished it, and it actually looks like the best place to put it is here. So what we're going to do is we're going to come down with our ladder right there. And how we're going to build this fireplace is we're going to place some netherrack right there. And we're going to find, where is it, some cobblestone. Just like so. And I mean, if you want to cover that up, you can too, but you should probably use a staircase or something. I don't know. I'm just going to leave that open like so. It's going to look ugly as hell. That's okay. It's okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to come through here. I might even fill in something like that. Yeah, we can do that. And that's pretty much it for the interior. If you want to spruce this up on the inside, that's fine by me. I honestly didn't do anything to it. I thought it kind of left it like that. The rest of the building is relatively polished as it is. Okay, we're gonna light the fire now. And one thing I have to tell you before you do it, you're gonna do it anyway, but I have to tell you, disclaimer, do not do this in survival mode. Do not do this in survival mode. Or if you cannot alter the settings of the server or creative world you're on, do not. It will burn down everything. Now, that being said, if you want to use fire instead of glowstone, because I think fire is cooler, we're gonna go game rule and then do fire tick, and then we're gonna set that to false. What that means is the fire is just not gonna spread, so we can light that up, and it's just gonna look gorgeous forever. And that's pretty much it. One last thing I forgot to show you is how I like to do it on the inside here. So how I generally like to do the inside of this lighthouse is just place some blocks like so and like that. It's just, it's nothing fancy, it's just gonna cap it off, make it look finished. Yeah, so that's about it. That's about it for today, guys. I do have a couple questions for you before you leave. Love for you to give me some feedback. I am putting them in the description just in case you didn't watch the whole video, but you are watching it now, and I really, really thank you for doing that, watching me all the way through. That's awesome of you. Now, I kinda wanna know, my channel's been going through kind of like a changing state recently. I've been working a lot with custom terrain, as you can see with this giant island here. I've been doing a little bit more Greymor builds. Like, I would consider this lighthouse kind of a Greymor style. It follows the same like roof patterns and architectural details as the Greymor houses did. I want to know what you want to see from my channel. Like, what kind of videos? Would you like to see cinematics? The thing with cinematics is it just takes a long time to make them. Tutorials, they're relatively easy to make. Showcases are probably the easiest thing to build, but I know they're not as good. Would you want like style tutorials? I know I've had a bunch of people request those, and I do plan on making something like that. Some kind of general tutorials. I think those are really nice. So yeah, what do you want to see from my channel? Like, what kind of videos? Do you want to see redstone like I used to do? Would you like to see some more Let's Play? I've come up with a bunch more of that stuff. I just haven't been recording it. And also, if I'm assuming we're going to be doing medieval for, or building for quite a while, what styles would you like to see me do? Because I have my Greymor style here, as you can see. I have my Nordic style, as you know all too well. And it's like, what would you like to see? Would you like me to see new styles or whatever? And just give me some feedback. Just put some recommendations in. Whether I follow them or not is more whether I feel inspired by them. I think there's not really a replacement for that inspirational feeling that you really get. So we'll see what we can do. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. That's about it. And yeah, so have a good day, everybody. Bye-bye.